It's the end of an era for a certain kind of media at a local radio station.
Aaron Farrar shows us what they are changing and how you can keep a piece of their history.
WUTC 88.1 is getting rid of these things, CDs.
Well, we're more and more automating the radio station every day. And I noticed that a lot of the younger disc jockeys especially were not using CDs. They were preferring to use their own collections.
Brian Lane is the station's manager. These 15,000 CDs are going on sale as WUTC's music is now 100% digital.
You don't have the booklet to read. You don't know about the artist. You don't know who wrote the song. Sometimes you don't know the lyrics. And that's a real emotional connection.
A 35-year collection of classic rock, blues, reggae, and this impressive jazz collection, 6,000 CDs. They will all be available to you, the public. In addition to the rotation they use on the air, they're also on a backup hard drive, just in case.
This has two copies right now itself on two separate computers, just in case that we had one that didn't function.
Whatever doesn't sell could end up in places like McKay's, which has brought in 11,000 UCDs so far this year.
Something that once feels obsolete does come back around. CDs do have a good quality, they have a good sound, and people want to listen to them. They still want to listen to them in their cars.
Powers and Lane think people will always want a hard copy of that disc in their hands.
They're still very much loved.
All of these CDs, including the ones in these bins, will be on sale starting this weekend. On Friday, every single CD will be $3. Then on Saturday, from 10 to 2, they'll move down at about $2. And then there will be a big doorbuster from 2 to 5. Every single CD that's left will be $1. Reporting in Chattanooga, I'm Aaron Farrar, News Channel 9.
Hey, I love that. Thanks, Aaron. Lane says it took the station more than 8 months to download all of its music into the computer system.